little six-year-old girl, and she'd been run over by a car the day before, left on the side of the road. She not only had a left frontal lobe hemorrhage and contusion, she had broken ribs on the right side with a hemopneumothorax, and she had a cracked liver that was bleeding. She remained on the ventilator for about 3 weeks, and we put a feeding tube in her to feed her. She slowly started to regain function, and about a month after she was admitted, she was able to walk out of here. Came back 4 weeks after her discharge, dressed like a little Afghan girl, with the eyeliner all the way around her eyes, wearing the scarf and acting like a normal six-year-old Afghan girl. Most of the sad and disturbing stories are the stories of the young kids and women that are injured out of the evil that comes through the Taliban and Al-Qaeda. I mean, they just want to kill people. They don't care who.
On September 11th, we got a report that there was an explosion in downtown Coast, and it had a number of injured people, including a number of small children. Four small boys were brought in, as well as a young man. And the story was that one of the boys was rolling a cart in downtown Coast, and reportedly an Al-Qaeda insurgent gave him a crate of pears and put it on his cart and said, take this to the local army commander's house, it's for him.
A young boy brought a bag and put it next to a small shop. There were nine children standing in and around the shop at the time. Suddenly we heard an explosion and then saw children scattered everywhere.
A boy came in with a bag and told us to give it to a man in our village. He set the bag in my family's shop, and then it exploded.
They're going to be fine. We just have to wait for to get enough nutrition in them so the wounds can heal, and we can either graft them or close them primarily.
So. The doctors here took good care of me.
I mean, from my own personal standpoint, my heroes are not movie stars or athletes. It's the Rangers and young Army men. And they're willing to risk their lives for the freedom of my children. And I'm a little too old to go out and do it myself. But I can be a surgeon and make sure that they understand that the people that take care of them care an awful lot about. Same blood around at the E-Forest. Looks good. Wrong.
We're going to put a C-collar on you just so that we can try to make sure that your head stays stable and all that good stuff, all right? Yeah. Once we get an IV in, we're going to give you some pain medicine.
There it is.
This courageous soldier recovered to full health. Watch over him. Give him strength. You're going to be alright, okay?
And we got three Americans in, and during that day, we weren't able to save one of them, and we tried for hours, and that was pretty hard. I cried a lot. For a while, and I'll always remember that soldier's name.
When you're done at the end of the day and you go back to your hooch, let's just say you just lost an American, which has happened, all that comes rushing back to you, and it is very difficult. I have had some very emotional days here. My first was soon after I had gotten here. Probably just a few weeks after I'd gotten here, we had lost an American soldier. And that's probably the toughest time I've ever had as a surgical technician. You want to be able to save everybody. It's just, it's not something that you can allow yourself to think about at the moment, because you know that you have a job to do.